This video is for those who present in a Zoom meeting on a regular basis. It is important for any presenter to engage and captivate their audience. Of course, your content must be relevant and interesting to your audience, but there are some other means to do that. And one way to captivate your audience is by asking live questions. You send a question to your audience on their mobile phones and they can instantly reply to those questions and you get a report. In this video, I'm going to show you a Zoom app that allows you to send 17 different types of questions to your audience or your students, because most of my subscribers are teaching online. So this video will be very useful, because asking questions during a live presentation is the best way to interact with your students and get the student participation very quickly and easily. So let me show you how you can achieve this. So first of all, let me show you that Zoom apps in product apps that are seamlessly integrated into Zoom. And if you want to know further, you can read these FAQs on Zoom website. As you can see, if you look at your Zoom interface on the right hand side, you have this apps button. Here there are two tabs, My Apps and Discover. In the Discover section, you can see that there are hundreds of Zoom apps in this area, and at the bottom even you can see that Discover More Apps on App Marketplace. Basically, this is a third party marketplace. Different vendors are developing these applications to add more features into Zoom, and the app which we are going to use is called Wooclap, as you can see here. If I click on that, and because I have already added this Zoom app into my Zoom account, I can see this open button here, but in your case you will see an add button, and you click on that add and then follow the prompt and the application will be installed. Now let me go back, and then when you will click on My Apps, you will see something like this. Wooclap will be available in My Apps, and now you are ready to use Wooclap. This is the app which allows you to add questions into your Zoom presentation. And now I'm going to start a Zoom meeting on my laptop as well as on my mobile phone, and I will show you how Wooclap works. Now I'm going to start a new meeting. So I click on that and join with computer audio, and I am joining without the video. And now I can click on these three dots, and I'm going to invite myself with another account. And I'm going to skip this part because I'm sure you know how to invite someone. And now I'm going to start Zoom application on my mobile phone. And now I have joined the meeting both on my laptop and on my mobile phone. And now I click on this apps icon at the bottom, and on the right hand side I can see my apps. So I'm going to click on this, and now I can share my app screen. I can invite users to use this app, and I can also expand to app view. So I click on that. Now this window has expanded now, and this is the one participant, as you can see here. And now I click on present an event, and this is my app window. Before you could present an event or a question, you have to create it. So I created one before, but I have deleted that. So I want to create a new one. So I click on create an event, and now this new window opens up. Let me maximize this. And now in this window, these are various types of questions which I can create as an event. Multiple choice, poll, word cloud, then open question, label an image, which is a new feature added recently, then find, on image, matching, brainstorming, slide, fill in the blanks, rating, where you can get some feedback about your online course to make improvements. Then find a number, audio, video, and there are 17 types of different questions in this. But we are going to demonstrate only one, so then you will be able to create any other type of question. And one thing I would like to mention is that I am on a basic Zoom account. I don't have any paid Zoom account, and I can still use Wooclap or any other app inside Zoom. However, there are few features that are paid features. First, let me create a multiple choice question. So I click on multiple choice question, and now a new window opens up, and I can type my question here. For example, I am a math teacher and I want to ask a simple question. So this is a simple question, and now I have to put answers here. So first answer could be 2xy, then xy, and then I click on plus x plus y. So I can put more options, but let us start with only 3. And this is the correct answer, so I tick on that and I can click save. And now in this area I have this one event which I can start or I can edit. If I click on edit, I go back to the same window again where I can edit. And if I cancel this, I can start from here, or I can even start from within the edit window. And now I want to start this event. I want to send this question to my students or my audience who are in this Zoom meeting. To do that, I click on start. And now, first of all, I will see this question, how it will appear to my audience. This is the question. These are 3 answers. And of course, they will not see this correct answer. This is only for me. If I have made any mistake, I can still correct it. But the important thing is that I have to send this link to my students or my meeting participants. They have to type this in the browser. They need internet to answer, of course. Also, I have this arrow. And if I click on this arrow, there is a QR code. This QR code will be presented to them. For example, if they are on a laptop, they can scan this code with their mobile phone and they will be able to answer my question, because they will be taken to the question. And if I click next, I will again see the same window. And now I'm going to type this on my mobile phone. And now I have typed this address in my browser window on my mobile phone, and I have reached on the question page. And now simply I have to select the answer. So let me select this one. And now instantly I have got this highlighted, and there is one written here. It means that one of my students have replied to my question. So as you notice that how simple it is to send any question to your students, and in the similar manner, other students can answer the question and I will get the report. How many students have answered the question correctly and how many have answered it wrong. And then if I am an online teacher, I can make some decisions that why students are answering these questions wrong, what is the problem, what concept I have to teach, and so and so. I can also get a feedback from my students by using this method about the course. So it is a very useful Zoom app that allows you to ask interactive questions to your students. And if I hover at the bottom, I can immediately create a new question, a new event, and send it to my students. And if I click on this little arrow, I can return to my apps. And on the right hand side, on these 3 dots, I can click and I can close this. So I hope you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.